Welcome back to the channel. I want to go over some more of the dust bust and show you a little bit of a node operation for adding your noise reduction. And then I had another concept with the depth map, which is on the studio only version, but it kind of isolates what's going on with your dirt removal subject. So let's take a look at this shot. Here we have, if I bypass everything, we got little dirt right in front of the actor here. You have a few, one over in the window on the front and behind. You have another one in the corner here. And also another dirt here in another shot, couple, pretty large one. So first and foremost, I added noise reduction on this first node. The reason I do it on the first node is because it can process. As you can see, it's blue. That means it's already gone through the shot and did its noise reduction. And if I make any downstream changes, it doesn't have to re-render. So do keep that in mind. It does matter order of operation for your nodes. So if you have like a magic mask or something where you're isolating, if you make an adjustment and it's down further, it's going to re-render every single time you just touch and make any kind of adjustment. So since I want noise reduction, sort of set it, forget it, put that as the first node. Second node is the depth map. Now with this one, my idea was to do a overall dirt removal. So with the depth map, if we turn on the preview and turn on our color effects, for whatever reason, it's going red. Normally it looks more like the key in the bottom here, but with invert on, it's basically affecting all the red portion and leaving the regular colored portion alone. So normally with invert off, it's going to latch onto that foreground based on our far limit adjustments here, which it does a pretty good job of doing that as soon as you drop it on. But you can adjust the far and near limit here and also adjust some of the isolation, softness, like blurring, things of that nature. But it did a pretty good job where I felt like the actor's face wasn't going to get bothered. So basically turned invert on, creating a safe zone on whatever's black, like we see in the key in the bottom here. And then that alpha is feeding into the dust buster. However, this is like a single frame operation. So I originally had the automatic, I think it's called automatic dirt removal on. And that's a bit different of a plugin. It kind of smears the surrounding pixels to get it to interpolate what it's supposed to look like. And that was a good case for isolating the foreground actor, but it kind of created some weird artifacting and I didn't think it was the best option for this. So let's go back to our regular automatic dirt removal here. So we'll check out the settings. So these are the ones I showed in another video where you actually draw a rectangle or an ellipse and you choose the area. It's kind of like patch replacer. So if we turn that on and off, you can see what it's doing. And if we bypass this color effect, I just kind of did a larger outline and I looked at it on my monitor to see how that line was interacting. And that's with no soft edge at all. So if we turn the overlay off here, there's the difference. This is also bypassing the noise reduction too. Here's with just the node on and off. And then if we go to the next, we have this dirt up here and the one over here on this side. Turn on the overlay. That shift tilde key to turn that on and off depending on what you have selected right over here. I have open effect overlay chosen so I can toggle these overlays on and off. You can also use this arrow key on the right for show patches. And so there's our two patches. Re-enable the node. Pretty clean job. And then for the last one was just a tiny patch over here. Normally I would have gone a little larger, but we have this gradient in blue kind of overlapping with what looks like a sign or something. So I went really small on that patch and that one looks pretty good. And the noise reduction definitely helps quite a bit. So if we bypass that one, let me see if I can zoom it in for you here. This works a little bit better with the motion blur as the shot's in motion. You can see the softening here, hopefully on YouTube, like around here, and there's some grain. This is more of a motion type effect. So that's those shots, the combination of noise reduction and the patching. And then for this next shot here, and let's bypass our effects. Hopefully you can see that. I back up. I did put a marker there, but we got this large, I don't know if that's dirt or just a scrape in the film. And then we had another little speck right here on the frame before. So here I just used the dust buster and that was it. And then if I move forward, you got the bigger patch for this last big piece of dirt here. But it really did a great job. And I do have the plus minus two frames. So whatever it did to put that fix in, it really did a nice job because you can't even tell it's there. And I don't really see anything at all. Even if we zoom in here to look over that fix, it's right where this marker is. So right there is the fix. And if we bypass, it's pretty clean. A little bit of a shifting when we're up this close, but you would never know, especially if you're zoomed out and you're watching the actors instead of the wall here. But it was a pretty large piece of dirt. So that's a little bit more sort of film restoration or problem solving with the dust buster. And from the previous shot, using the depth map to kind of have a unaffected zone here on the actor instead of the whole shot. Because you would rather have some artifacting going on in the background, or if anything's going to happen, rather than right on your focal point or your main subject. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.